Several methods for the quantitative evaluation of drug-combined interaction effects have been used. A brief description of the principles and limitations of the different methods will be discussed in the subsequent videos. Methods following an effect-based strategy compare the effect resulting from the combination of two drugs directly to the effects of its individual components. The exact decision process that allows a conclusion of positive, negative, or null combination effect can vary among four main strategies, which are: combination subthresholding, highest single agent, response additivity, and Bliss independence model. The combination subthresholding approach consists of showing that combination of non-effective doses of drugs yields significant effect. Effectiveness is generally declared based on a p-value resulting from a statistical test versus an untreated control group below the 0.05 level. The application of this simple approach is common. However, effectiveness declared based on a threshold does not necessarily imply a convincing difference between the effect of the drug combination and the effects of its individual components. Consider a scenario in which the drug combination barely reaches significance and its individual components narrowly fail to reach significance. Although these effects lie on opposite sides of 0.05, the difference between significant and not significant is not itself necessarily significant, and one cannot be convinced of a positive improvement in effect by the drug combination compared to the drugs taken individually. The highest single-agent approach, or cooperative effect, simply reflects the fact that the resulting effect of a drug combination is greater than the effects produced by its individual components. A combination index can be calculated using the formula shown here, and the significance of a positive effect is given by the p-value of the statistical test, comparing the combination to the highest single agent. The highest single-agent approach represents an improvement compared to the previous combination sub-thresholding approach, interpreting the significance of differences rather than the difference of significances. It provides evidence of the superiority of the drug combination compared to its single agents. However, by comparing the combination directly to the highest single agent, this approach fails to demonstrate an improved drug combination effect compared to the expected additive effect of its individual components. As a consequence, a positive result obtained with the highest single-agent approach indicates a positive drug combination effect with an amelioration compared to the single drugs considered alone, but provides a very limited evidence of synergy except in the case where at least one drug is known to be inactive at any concentration. The response additivity approach, also referred to as linear interaction effect, consists in showing that a positive drug combination effect occurs when the observed combination effect is greater than the expected additive effect given by the sum of the individual effects. The combination index can be calculated as shown here, and the corresponding p-value is given by the significance of the interaction effect in a factorial analysis of variance of the individual and combination effects. The response additivity approach can appear as a natural improvement of the highest single agent to assess synergy, as it compares the observed combination effect to an expected effect from additivity instead of the effect of the single agents. A major limitation of the response additivity model is the fact that assumes drugs have linear dose effect curves with zero intercepts, which is generally not the case, as most dose effect curves are characterized by logistic or curvilinear shapes. Bliss independence is based on probability theory and assumes the two inhibitors are working through independent mechanisms. The inhibitors do not interfere with each other, but contribute to a common result. Unlike low additivity, calculating Bliss independence does not require determination of dose-response curves for the individual compounds to determine the theoretical results, making it easier to compute. Bliss independence calculates the combined effect as the product of the individual effects with drugs A and B. The predicted combined effect is computed by the formula here, where each effect is expressed as fractional activity compared to control between 0 and 1. For example, if drug A and drug B each result in 40% tumor growth compared to control, then the predicted tumor growth, when combined, would be 0.4 times 0.4 times 100% equals to 16% of control, according to Bliss independence. The predicted combined inhibition level would therefore be 100% minus 16%, equal to 84% inhibition of tumor growth. If the actual tumor growth when drug A and drug B are combined is less than 16% of control, then the compounds would be synergistic by Bliss independence. If the tumor growth level is greater than 16% of control, then the compounds would be defined as antagonistic. The observed combination effect can then be compared to the expected additive effect, given by the common formula for probabilistic independence. The resulting combination index can be calculated using the formula shown here. Opponents to the effect-based approaches consider that the proper way to compare different agents having nonlinear dose effect curves is to find what amount or concentration of each produces the same quantitative effect. This is known as the dose effect-based approaches. The expected additive effect of a combination depends on the individual dose effect curves and enables the formulation of unequivocal definitions of synergy, additivism, and antagonism. In particular, dose effect-based approaches rely on the mathematical framework known as low additivity. Low additivity builds on the concepts of dose equivalence and sham combination. The dose equivalence concept assumes that both compounds that reach the same effect can be interchanged. The sham combination concept assumes that a compound does not interact with itself. Mathematically, the concentration of drug A and drug B, which alone results in an effect on the target, can be used to calculate the theoretical concentrations of each drug needed to achieve the same effect when combined. For example, if 50% inhibition is achieved separately by 1 micromolar of drug A or 1 micromolar of drug B, a combination of 0.5 micromolar of drug A and 0.5 micromolar of drug B should also produce 50% inhibition. Using the same formula, one can plot an isobologram where X and Y axes represent concentrations of drug A and drug B to achieve a defined effect. If the defined effect is 50%, then the coordinate at A0 will represent the IC50 for drug A, and the coordinate at 0B will be the IC50 for drug B. The line of additivity can then be constructed by connecting these two points for a 50% effect isobologram plot. The concentrations of the two drugs used in combination to provide the same effect will be denoted by point X and Y, and are placed in the same plot. Synergy, additivity, or antagonism will be determined when this point is located below, on, or above the line, respectively. More generally, linear, concave, and convex isoboles represent non-interacting, synergy, and antagonistic drug combination, respectively. The low additivity approach led to the development of the combination index model. The combination index provides a quantitative measure of the extent of drug interaction at a given effect. It measures the combination concentrations of drug A and drug B to produce an effect, normalized by their corresponding concentrations that produces the same effect as a single agent. The combination index can be calculated by the formula shown here, where CI value of less than 1 equals to 1 and more than 1 represents synergy, additivity, and antagonism, respectively. In summary, methods to generate and analyze data have evolved substantially over time, thanks to substantial improvements in screening technologies and computational capacities. Experimental characterization of drug combinations typically involves generating dose-response curves with the inhibitors separately and combined. The combination effects can then be compared to single agent alone using either of the method described here or a collective use of multiple approaches. Regardless, elucidating the mechanisms of action by which drugs cause their single and joint actions will help improving the science behind formulating combination drugs.